I've been asked before that is the only toothpaste brand I use, Darby.
Huh?
If y'all understand the reason behind it, y'all will understand the reason behind it. Yes. GG lah, bro.
Welcome to Good Game Well Played, the talk show with a twist.
Every episode, we talk about topics in our society.
All while playing fun games.
At the end of the day, we just want to have a good discussion and play some games.
Feelings might get hurt.
People will get shook.
But hey, at the end, we can all say,
good game, well played.
Oh, and finally, the points don't matter.
Huh? Points don't matter?
Yeah lah, the points don't matter.
Ah, then like that how?
Faster lah, stop wasting time, stop asking so much questions. Faster, faster!
Hello everyone, I'm Waikin.
Hi, I'm Leah.
I'm Alvin. This is Nancy, this is Wendy.
So on this episode today, we're actually going to be talking about something a bit serious, but hopefully we don't go too deep into that. It's about casual racism and how it affects us. So first off, right, one-liners of something that you've actually experienced. Like maybe we go around, I think every one of us.
Yeah.
So
I was having lunch with my colleague, this older auntie that was clearing the tables, and she walked by and she told my colleague in Chinese, saying, look at her, Africans, when they're lighter, they're prettier. People hey the fuck can. My colleague was just like, because I understand. I was just like, I'm scared. Never mind.
It'd be quite messed up if you were at the table at that time.
Oh, Dave, yeah.
Oh yeah, that's why I messed up.
No. I've been asked before that is the only toothpaste brand I use, Darby.
Huh?
If y'all understand the reason behind it, y'all will understand the reason behind it.
But when people say like, instead of having the beach, I wear black already.
Well, I go to the beach, but I same color as you now, eh.
Bruh.
Yeah.
Okay, just...
You think you go the sun one time, you make okay.
For me, it's only when I travel. If I'm in the English-speaking country, they say, oh, you speak English very well. Chinese, oh, you are you
Biao-zhun. I've actually gotten the same remark before. I was buying drink, and this person was like, oh, where are you from? Is that from Tanzania? I say, oh, wow, your English is very good.
Sorry,
thanks.
Where am I supposed to speak it?
Yeah.
What am I supposed to speak it?
Yeah.
How do you define casual racism?
I feel like colorism is it's become something that everyone just become accustomed to, and somehow it becomes okay. It's like it's racism that has somehow become socially accepted. Like it's being done so often, being said so often that everyone just sees it as okay.
It's kind of like taking someone out of their race and making it just about the race, but oh, it's not about you, it's just like it's about other people. Like, you're very pretty for an African. It's like, what's that supposed to mean? You make me feel nice, but then again, are you saying that Africans are not pretty? It's like a backhanded compliment almost.
Mm.
Yep. I think what's happening right now, people just say things without thinking, but people don't understand that their words hold a lot of power in there.
Mm.
And if I say something to someone, someone's gonna take it how they think it's intended for them.
Mm.
So there's a lot of lost in translation, maybe.
It's a bit messed up how. Sometimes people will tell you like, oh, never mind, it's just a joke. No offense kind of thing.
Yeah.
And it kind of makes you grow up thinking that this is okay. Like, you're expected to deal with racial remarks as though it's normal.
Yeah.
I didn't know how much this like affected me in that sense, but I realized that, or rather I had ideas of like, oh, if you're lighter skin, then you are more prettier. And I realized that, oh, I actually did want to like become lighter at one point of time because like, I felt, maybe you'll be more like acceptable like to other people, or it's a human thing like to want to feel like you belong to someone or you belong to a group. But I feel like as much as we try to be inclusive, maybe we should place our, you know, place our belonging, not like a
place our belonging,
and
not
trying
to feel like you belong.
And I think culturally, African American versus where. Oh.
Is that counted?
Does that mean
that the game
has ended? I'll save you, don't worry.
It's also a very different experience. And
I'm sorry.
But I'm sorry, now my hands are like shaking because I'm like...
Big arms are heavy.
Okay, wait, I got this.
I guess that also shows, yes, people may have that intention, good intention, right? But at the same time, it's also how how it really feels out at the end of the day. And I think that's where it's also, it reflects quite a lot on our society. Yes, people may have good intentions, right? But the question is really, who do you hold in mind? You know, you may have the intention to do something good, but are you really holding the person's feelings, the person's experience in mind and holding their space for them? Yeah, and really, really understanding, hey, how would they experience it rather than, oh, you know, I feel good saying this.
Yeah, so okay, so that's it, right? When it comes to comedy then, is there a line? When is something funny? To make people laugh about it, but also think about the truth behind it. Mm-hmm. So when is it crossing the line?
I feel like for this, especially for comedy, it's definitely...
Let's go.
It is all.
It is shaking.
It's like my life in one hour.
So no pressure, if you lose, it's just 10,000 points.
Just 10,000.
Just 10,000 points.
That's like a fine... Or a grey area, like with accents also and impressions.
Yes, yes.
Because if you are not that race and you mimic the accent or you mock it or you don't do it well, and then it comes off as like casual racism, even though maybe your intention was not that way.
So if I act very well, then can I?
So that's the thing. So there are comedians that are very well, do accents really well, and they are not get, they don't get called out for it.
In our case, in our local context, you guys know of Kuma, right?
Yeah. And I wanted to have dim sum, you know, because I came from Taiwan. I mean, it's dim sum, right? And then it's everywhere, it's so halal. It's so boring. Like, I had to have dumpling chicken. Like, it doesn't smell Chinese. I don't like it. It smells tudung. I can't do that. 60 ringgit, no. It's a lot of money for you. Now,
But what if it was a Chinese comedian who did those jokes that he did?
I guess when we twist it around and we change the perspective, if our answer is no, then there's something wrong.
Correct, right? Yeah.
Like,
correct,
there's something to...
I really think it evolved as a generation.
Honestly, these are so hard to think.
I think we have evolved as like last time, maybe 20 years ago, these jokes were like, okay, because generations now are all very different. So I think it's what we have to grow and adapt to, and like but also because of how we are perceiving everything now.
Yeah.
The thing about comedy is that there's no one joke that everyone finds funny, sadly.
True.
So there'll always be that comedian that certain people won't find funny. And say if I was, and then if I were to make, like, you know, I would talk about, you know, the experiences I had growing up, like the kind of struggles that I had, everything. You, that's a struggle right there. Come on, sorry, I'm like, sorry, don't fall. Let's say I want to, you know, be a comedian, then I thought the struggles black people go through.
Yeah.
And then let's say you can have everyone who like who relate to it, be like, oh yeah, yeah, that's true. But then you can have that one person who just doesn't find the jokes funny and they'll just straight take it as offense.
Correct.
It's not like a not that funny kind of thing. People tend to go the other extreme. And I mean, no offense, but our current generation is a bit sensitive nowadays.
Precisely because now we are more aware of race issues.
Yeah.
That we are now also becoming more sensitive.
Mm-hmm.
So is this the trend?
I think it's a very fine line. To what extent are we being too sensitive also?
No, then some things are not racist, but then
they make it racist.
It was never intended. Everyone looks out for each other's feelings, I guess.
Isn't that good?
It's good to a way, but to a certain extent, like so, everything so literal.
Basically, to summarize, it's a balance.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, so then how do we create a more inclusive society?
You need to work together, but it's not going to come out.
No, you're not supposed to work together. That's definitely the rule.
But in society.
In society.
Yeah, true.
That's right.
Yeah, I think it's definitely understanding.
No.
It was at this moment that he knew. He f***ed up.
So I think the answer to that would be more talking. Talking about how we feel, like when someone says something, we should just honestly say, okay, this doesn't feel good.
Mm-hmm.
And then try to find a way to, you know, do things better. So anyway, that was what this whole show was all about. It's about frank conversation with each other. So 15,000 points to this team.
Yes.
And at the end of the game, we say good game,
well played.
That was the end of this episode of Good Game, Well Played, and...
Okay, if you like this video, you can give it a like. You can leave a comment down below if you want us to talk about certain topics, and maybe that will be our next episode.
Yep.
Bye.
Thanks for watching. Thank you.